Ready for your countdown?
Yeah, then what happens?
Five. Well, I'm already filming, so...
Yeah, but I mean, what are we filming?
You.
Why? I mean, doing what?
You're a star.
This is an anniversary show. Say happy anniversary to the Night Shadow.
So what do I do?
24 years on the air.
No.
We're our 1,000th episode. We'll just say it's a...
Welcome back here to Horror Kung Fu Theater, and it's unbelievable. We have a really special guest, very beautiful horror icon, PJ Souls. Miss Souls?
Hello.
Oh,
nice data.
There you are. Thank you very much for doing this interview.
Absolutely.
So I get a lot of people
My pleasure for the Night Shadow.
Thank you. Because I get a lot of people that I go up to and they just like throw rocks at me or something like that. Let me tell you people out there, when I first met her, it was at a convention. Very nice lady. Very nice. Very approachable. Like I said, there was no rocks around her or nothing where she can throw them at me.
Hey, you were nice too.
Oh, thank you. But don't tell people that. I'm a bad guy, really. So.
Oh, okay. Nice, but... Okay.
Yeah. Miss Souls is a horror icon, I guess. I would say she was a scream queen before that word was so loosely interpreted.
Yes, but I had done so many other things. I don't know. Maybe because Carrie was my first real movie that people think I'm...
Yeah,
queen.
That's what I was going to say. You would probably know...
Right. Rock and Roll High School, not exactly Scream Queen, although there is some screaming on the stove with Bill Murray and Stripes, I have to say.
Well, you guys will remember her from the original Halloween, which is that movie in itself is the top 10 of the films. And probably even...
Who would have thought it would have lasted this long? It's unbelievable.
That's what I was going to ask you. Did you think that movie was going to be as popular as it was?
Gosh, no way. I mean, we were hoping people would like it, but we didn't think it would have the life span that it has. It's just amazing. It's totally amazing.
Now, go ahead and say a couple more films that you're in so we could look them up, or some of these morons in the TV.
Well, Carrie was my first film, and I have a red baseball cap.
Yeah, the one she has a red baseball cap on. Can't miss her.
Yeah. So that was good. Definitely Rock and Roll High School with the Ramones.
Yep.
Loved that movie. And certainly Stripes with Bill Murray. These seem to be the movies that people just, can't get enough of, and they keep showing on TV all the time and Netflix and everything. So it's really quite astounding to me. And certainly when I go to conventions and I meet people and the generations, the people are getting younger and younger who come to my table and go, oh, I love Halloween, or Stripes is my favorite movie. I love the Ramones. So it's amazing.
You were in Stripes?
I was the girl on the stove with Bill Murray.
Oh, I was going to say,
Who's your buddy?
You weren't the mud wrestler, were you?
No, I got the spatula treatment, much better than mud wrestling, John.
And also, a movie that I enjoyed was The Butterfly Room.
Oh, okay, yeah. That was most more recently.
Yeah, with Barbara Steele.
Far back. I love Barbara Steele. I really only had a little tiny cameo in that, but I loved the director, and I thought, the script was terrific. I would have loved to have been had the Barbara Steele part, but she was awesome in it, and it was great to meet her for the, short amount of time I was on the set, and I thought she did a great job.
She did.
Very, for as we age, you always wonder, gosh, what are we going to look like and blah, blah, blah. But Barbara Steele aged pretty well. So I think she holds up the movie pretty well.
And I don't mean to be disrespectful, but she looked like a creepy old lady, man. She was scary.
Yeah, very scary.
You know how she
was scary in real life, too.
Really? Yeah, because
I think she was one of those people. Sometimes people, when you work with them on set, they stay in character, and so she was in character even though we were introduced and about to do our scene together. She maintained being in character, I think, until the end of the day. So some people do that,
Now, she hasn't, since we're talking about her, she hasn't, that's the first movie in a while she's done recently, hasn't it?
I think so. I don't really know much about her. I think possibly she lives in Italy or New York. I'm not sure. But, yeah, I have never seen her at any of the conventions, so I haven't really gotten to know her at all. I just, you know, met her for our brief little scene that I had with a girl playing my little daughter, you know.
Yeah. Now, who did you rather get killed by, Michael Myers or Carrie? Which one did you prefer?
My character in Halloween didn't know what was going on. Linda thought that was Bob under the sheet.
Yeah.
How naive was Linda, which is ridiculous. Why call Lori? You know, you can't get your guy back in bed. You're going to go call Lori. And then there was, you know, scary Sissy, but who thought that the fire hose was going to take me out? But it's a good question. Probably Michael Myers, only because, you know, I had one-on-one scene with him as opposed to the whole prom scene when everyone was getting blasted by the fire hose.
Yeah. How was that? Was it Duran that did the Michael Myers in that film, or the
Tony Moran, you mean?
Yeah. Oh, that's right. The cousin?
Tony Moran was actually at the end of the movie when Michael Myers takes his mask off.
Yeah.
Face. That's the only time that Tony Moran is there. In my scene, the guy under the sheet was Nick Castle because I think Tommy Wallace had to go out and run an errand or something, but it was either Nick or Tommy that were, you know, putting on the jumpsuit and the mask for the Michael Myers actions. Whoever was available at the time.
Isn't he a friend of Carpenter's, Nick Castle?
Yes, well, both of them, yeah, three of them, I think, went to USC together, a film school, and that's where they met, and I think they had a band together, so that's, yeah, and they performed, you know, the theme song, that was them doing that, so they were a tight group there.
They made some money, then.
A fun project that they were doing to get started. I don't think they ever, in their wildest dreams, thought it was going to do what it's done, so amazing.
Now, tell me about some things happen on the set of other movies that you, or do you work, people that you work with that you really liked?
Well, on Carrie, everybody, it was mostly our first movie, so Nancy Allen, we still are friends to this day. I'm going to see her next weekend at Motor City Nightmares in Detroit, and you know, when we see each other at conventions, we usually go to lunch or dinner.
Oh, tell her I say hi.
And it's just usually so much fun to think, you know, it's like a high school reunion or a college reunion, getting together with these people that you work with on a movie that you never, you know, lose that closeness because you've spent so much time in such an intimate setting that, you know, just kind of you're bonded forever. And Sissy Spacek was wonderful. She was married to Jack Fisk, who was the set designer, and he made that whole look of especially Sissy and Piper Laurie's house so special. I mean, that was a pretty creepy closet she had to go into and print.
Yeah, it was. That's where my wife puts me in the closet at home.
So, and Piper Laurie, I've gotten to know. She and I and Nancy Allen went up to my friend Michael Clark. He has a Movie Madness video store, and he got together with an old movie theater up there, the Hollywood Theater in Portland, and put on a screening of Carrie. So the three of us, he flew us up there and took good care of us. And we, you know, did a bunch of Q&As and signings. And she's just a delightful lady, too. She has a book out now, actually, on her life story, something I would like to do one of these days.
Yeah, you should do that.
Write my story. It's called The Totally Girl. But
there's a lot involved in that.
But them and then Jamie Lee Curtis. You know, if I saw her in the street or if we called each other up and said, hey, let's get together, you'd still have that bond. You know,
oh, that's cool.
We were very close for years, but then you get married, you have kids, you know, your life goes in different directions.
Life happens. Yeah.
John Lennon says.
I was going to say, I'd hardly see, which I could be wrong, but I could hardly see any appearances that you go to, like as far as signing and all that. And I seen you at that Nuke the Fridge, and they, you know, nothing against Nuke the Fridge, but they didn't have you on their site showing up. I just seen you there because I was, of course, being a member of the NWO, the wrestling faction,
right,
with Nash.
So,
and,
yeah, so Roddy Piper was there.
Yeah, Nash, Hogan, and Razor Ramon, and they were there, so that's why I was there. And then I seen you, and I said, oh, my God.
Well, I don't know what happened with the advertising for that, but, yeah, I don't do too many in L.A. My manager, Bill Philiput, he is part of the Days of the Dead conventions, and so now that they have their foothold in L.A., I used to do some of the ones, like, at the Burbank Airport, the Marriott there, and some other ones, but now mostly Days of the Dead, which is, you know, has grown. It's become better and better every year, but there aren't so many in the Los Angeles area. But I do, you know, like I said, I'm going to Motor City in Detroit next, and then a couple weekends after that, I'm going to Nashville for Ben and Stacy Dixon's Full Moon and Tattoo Festival, and that's always really fun.
Wow.
Because it's right at Music City Center at in Nashville, and so you just walk out the door, and you're right on that street where there's a band playing in every single place. So you can get your fill of barbecue and music in Nashville, so it's always fun to go there. Plus, the fans are great. And most of the fans are great in every convention. Monster Mania I just went to in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. Fantastic fans.
But you know, they have some weirdos that come too, don't you?
There's never really, you know, people always ask me that. They might dress weird. They might have a lot of tattoos. The last one at Monster Mania in Cherry Hill, a guy had a tattoo on his leg of Bill Murray. I've never seen that. Usually it's Michael Myers. Sometimes it's Joey Ramone. But this guy had a Bill Murray tattoo, which was really funny because the next week this guy, friend of mine, asked me if Jim Towns, he's a director, if I would, you know, they're doing a little documentary. He and his friend, a wonderful actress, Sadie Katz, is doing this documentary on the whole Bill Murray phenomenon. And since I worked with him in Stripes, they said, could you just do a little interview, you know, sit on the couch with Sadie and talk about, you know, what it was like working with Bill Murray. And I said, yeah, the last weekend this guy had a Bill Murray tattoo, and I'm so used to skulls and, you know, like I said, Michael Myers or the pumpkin or the knife or something.
Yeah.
But, you know, you never see that. So, but really, it's become more and more a family affair. People bring their kids to these conventions. People, you know, let their kids, when they're 3 years old, watch Halloween, which I find amazing. My son didn't get to watch it till he was 13.
Yeah, I went up.
That was his mother, you know, saying, see anything you like. So we had to be a little careful there.
Yeah. Now, do you have a website you want to give out or anything like that for, you know?
No, just on Facebook you can find me, and, you know, I used to have a website, but since Facebook is really, you know, the place where everybody goes to, there's, you know, I don't sell anything, so it's not like I have T-shirts or anything to sell.
Not till you get your book.
That's right, when I have my book, but then, you know, then I'll bring it with me to the conventions or have some book signings around, so, but I do, I have to get on it, but there's been a lot. Just this past week went through a lot of my mother's stuff that my brother had dropped off, and there were lots of letters that I had written to my parents in the 70s, and it was, you know, a lot of good reading and reminded me of things that I'd totally forgotten about, so.
Yeah. Have you tried going to Kamikaze convention over here at the LA?
No, I did go to that. I went because Kim Gottlieb Walker, she was the set photographer on a bunch of John Carpenter movies, including Halloween, and she has a beautiful photo book out, just gorgeous, gorgeous. And they asked her to come down there and sign, and so she asked if I'd go with her, and we did. We were sitting in a T-shirt booth, and we weren't advertised as such. People would just kind of be looking for a T-shirt and go, is that PJ Fools?
Yeah.
So that was kind of weird. I helped a lot of people find extra large T-shirts, but...
Then they
bought a picture, but it was kind of strange.
Yeah, that's one you got to go to when if you do that book, because.
But my boyfriend went with me, and it was amazing because we're not so familiar with that world, the anime world, and it was pretty amazing. You know, he's like, all these people are dressed up in characters that I have no idea who they are.
Yeah.
But they look really cool.
Yeah. No, we do a live show. A panel show over there for every year since they started. over there. So,
this
yeah.
This is a Stan Lee one you're talking
yeah,
about.
Stan Lee yeah. and Elvira.
It was
Stan...
awesome. It was just unbelievable how many people are there. We could not believe it was just flooded. And everyone was in costume, which was amazing.
Yeah, it's getting bigger and bigger every year, but...
Oh, it was huge.
Yeah.
I mean, it was huge.
Well, Miss Souls, I want to thank you again for even putting up with the silliness show.
Don't be silly. So is it your 14th anniversary or
no,
24? Okay, because in your email to me, you said 14 years.
Oh, that's...
But then I looked you up on Facebook, and it said 24 years. So
yeah.
Somewhere he lost 10 years in his email.
Well, I also used to do wrestling, so I think I had too many hit chairs in the head and stuff like that.
Okay.
So.
Well, congratulations. That's pretty amazing. And, you know, you should have some of the other wrestlers that were at the Nuke the Fridge. Because have you ever had Roddy Piper on? Because he's such a nice guy.
No.
Or is that a different kind of wrestling? Or is he the same kind of wrestling?
What's his name? The Rock?
Roddy, yeah. No, I didn't know if there's different kinds.
Because
I know there's those Santos, the Saints, that were the from Mexico.
Yeah, that's called Lucha Libre.
Lucha Libre. Yeah,
Guy actually died about 2 weeks ago in the rain.
What?
Yeah.
Both of them?
Well, no, it was just one of them. It was, I don't know if you ever heard of the wrestler Rey Mysterio. He used to be with WWE.
No.
Yeah, well, he accidentally, you know, because even though... It is entertainment, you know. A lot of people don't realize that sometimes we really take a hit or something, and things happen.
Oh no!
Yeah, it was a tragedy. Yeah,
Oh, that's so sad. Because I was in a movie that Jeff Burr directed, and he had me come down to St. Louis, and I actually was like an MC, and those guys were there, and it ended up being a good thing I was there because they didn't speak English, and I was raised part of my life in Maracaibo, Venezuela, and I speak Spanish, so I became like the director's translator for the week.
Oh, wow.
But I remember they would never take their masks off because they didn't want anyone to know what they looked like. And,
yeah, well, actually, I wear a mask. That's why I didn't wear it that day, but
okay.
I wear a mask. I never took it off.
I know what he looks like, everyone.
Yeah, that's a secret. I take it off for two reasons. So, because I'm a villain, the people that hate me don't know who I am, and I'm not very attractive.
That's a good one. I bet that's not true.
Oh, it's true. Well, Ms. Souls, again, I want to thank you for coming
so
on.
You are so welcome. It was very nice talking to you again. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All of your endeavors, and I hope to see you again in another Nuke the Fridge. It was fun.
If you're around L.A. anywhere, I'll find you.
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much.
Take care.
Bye-bye. And that was P.J. Souls, a horror icon. And some of you younger idiots out there, like, doing the cameras, don't even know who it is, man. Who's that? You ever hear of Halloween? Oh, yeah, I seen it. Well, she was the one, Lori's friend. I don't remember. All right. Well, that is our special 24th anniversary show that we're having. That's just the beginning, people. The beginning. 24 years. And we will be approaching 1,000 episodes in a couple of months. What the heck is that? So, and also today, as guests on the show, the regular weirdos, of course. We are going to be playing the awesome, one of my favorite movies, Dr. Frankenstein's Castle of Freaks. Oh, you got to see this, man. Oh. And Super Ninjas. You know, horror, kung fu. I don't think we've been putting up any kung fu flicks up for a while because you're slacking. No, not you. Him. Even though you don't do that. But we also have, and the return of, quit doing that. The return of the Armenian comedian, And my buddy Niels Stewart is supposed to be here. He was going to bring his son, but his son's in Coachella. His son, Boo Boo. He's not here right now, so I could say something. He named his kids Boo Boo and Fivel. So, but he's too big and mean to say anything about that. So that's why I don't say anything when he's here. But his son played in X-Men, the latest movies, Days of Future Past, and he was Warpath in the movie. I haven't seen him since he was like 6 or 7 years old, man. So also, like I said, the regular weirdos, we have also Crystal Man and a psychic dog. That's right, you heard me, ladies and gentlemen. A psychic dog. And we also have a special guest that's going to break open a can of worms on the secrets. What do? We did the UFOs last time? Oh, monsters! But he's got to be in disguise because he knows stuff from the government about monsters that are actually the government knows, and he's going to break the case wide open and stuff. And his name is Sullivan Punjabi.
The government's watching you.
Oh, sorry, government. All right, so we'll be back. 24 years. Hey, look at this, look at this. What the heck is that? Why do you stop doing that? Can you check who's out there for me?
And here, much to my delight, is the stinger. In order to give this grand house and community one last look at my family's immorality and insanity, it is decreed that each of you must live on the premises for one full week, starting right now, in order to qualify for your well-earned inheritance. I shall pause for your reaction. Knowing you as I do, I am sure you are responding in the true family tradition. But, my dear children, had you intelligence and perhaps a tinge of virtue, you'd tell me to take the money to hell with me, and you'll go home to whatever kind of worthless lives you now live.
We ask you to accept the remains of this man. We ask you to receive this man into thy bosom. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Welcome to your reunion.
I will be done.
And from me, I give you a last farewell.
Faggots for the devil. Goodbye, you ornery bastard.
Vaughn! Hey, I want to congratulate the Night Shadow on the 24th anniversary of doing his wonderful, wonderful show. Yay! Well, there's almost 1,000 years of shows, right? That wrapped up in 24.
Yeah, 1,000 episodes.
1,000 episodes. Can you imagine? Can you wrap your brains around 1,000? I can. I count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I could do it really quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And guess what, folks? That's why they call me the Count.
Yeah!
All right. I'm very honored to be here today. I'll attempt to do a song which I don't know all that well. But this was in a movie that was one of the voice movies. I mean, best, I mean, horrible. I mean, it's a movie. Put it that way. It's called Tales from the Crapper by Troma Entertainment, the greatest film company in the history of the universe. This was the theme song. I heard they liked it in the Soviet Union, or what they call the former one. Former Soviet Union, you understand? It's called Tales from the Crapper. like sex and violence. I like blood and guts. I like the sound of silence till it drives me totally nuts. If you're coming down, you better watch your yapper. How many souls did have an underground watching tales from the clapper? I like naked strippers ripping off arms and heads. Makes me feel so chipper to know they're completely dead. And if you dare to show up stinking like some old red snapper, please don't make me throw up. I'm watching Tales from the Clapper. I'm into perversion. I'm into gore. I wish there was another version. I'd watch this movie some more. Look how dapper is the master of the clapper. I like shrieks and screamings. That's, of course, what you get. Do you get my meaning? Is there any meaning at all to get? And if my girlfriend bugs me, I don't go and slap her. I lock her up in a room and make her watch Tales from the Clapper. Hey! It's highfalutin, it's culture, it's art, it's the rooty toot-tootin, watch them tear the geeks apart, show them who's the real scrapper, it's the master of the clapper. So sit here and watch it, don't you disappear, you'll see things so strange. You'll see things so clear. And if you shriek, that's okay. So what if you make an apple? After all, there's only one thing to say. Watch Tales from the Clapper. Ow-woo! Ow-woo! Wow.
Wow.
Nice. So what's shaking now? We got another one?
Yeah.
Okay, this one is an ode to my ancient homeland, Smokesylvania. And it's the title of my beautiful album here, my CD, which nobody buys anymore because it's all downloads, and it's downloadable on Amazon, YouTube, iTunes, whatever. I shouldn't have said YouTube. You could see some of it there. This is called Smokesylvania in My Mind. And if I had one, that would be the truth. But basically, I've shrunk in my mind to the size of a peanut so that my weight would go down. It's a technique of weight control that we learned from Jenny Craiglist back in Smokesylvania many thousands of years ago. Which was transmitted, you know, through the Vysotskivan. Everybody know what the Vysotskivan is?
No!
Let me explain to you. You heard about the television? We had a television in Smokesylvania, but we called it a Vysotskivan. The difference was we had no electricity in Smokesylvania. So the ancient Smokesylvanians, being the couch people, the potatoes of the couch that they were, they would sit up on the couch and pop the Vysotskivan with their feet furiously to keep the picture going. And in that way, they stayed healthy and long living. I'm 496. It's a testimony to my Vysotskivaning as a youth.
Yeah,
let's go. I'm miserable. I'm feeling blue. just what I'm gonna do. I will resist the urge to let myself go. I'll lay my head upon a pillow underneath some vegan willow and leave a daisy smoke Sylvania long ago. I'm gonna smoke. Crowded in a bus, I get so mad, I'm on a cusp, and it's so warm that I might break a fry. I close my eyes and sounds I'm hearing a paradise that is nearing. I dream of days that smoke so many long gone by. I'm gonna smoke Sylvania. Now let me explain ya. I'm gonna leave all my troubles far behind. In smoke Sylvania. No one tries to tell ya. I'm going to smoke Sylvania. What a great audience here.
Did you guys want to do that?
Carl.
Yes, darling?
Come to Leslie. I need you. My daddy didn't hate me. Did he?
Of course not.
And Johnny. We must be careful not to say anything to him until the time is right.
That's correct.
Do you think Johnny still hates me?
No, we don't know that as yet.
Oh, we will. We will, won't we?
Of course we will. And now I want you to get some rest.
Yes, Doctor. You do love me, don't you, Carl?
You know I do.
Carl, I know everything about you. You're such a kind man. Oh, I love you so much for that. Tell me that you love me.
I do.
Say it. Say it.
I love you.
Greetings, everybody.
Yay!
It's Dana Davenport, and congratulations, Night Shadow, for your 24th anniversary.
Yay, so, for me!
Excitement, excitement.
Yeehaw!
Want to sing a song called Rocky Road about a guy's having some trouble with his lady friend. I guess it's time for my monthly summon. Once again, seemed I've stepped out of line. You can't understand why I don't conform. Don't believe me when I say I'm trying. You say lose your balance on the straight and narrow. Sure put it on those bumps and bends. How come you always choose the rocky road? Maybe the rocky road's the only road I know. Think there's safety in the straight and narrow. Sure that pike's burning is freedom bound. Steady at first, then you can't turn around, and your fate becomes that possum in the road. Lose your balance on the straight and narrow. Sure-footed on those bumps and bends. How come you only choose the rocky road? Maybe the rocky road's the only road I know. There's no deceit in an honest answer, but roads aren't always what they appear to be. Straight may mean slick, narrow feels so tight. At least the rocky road lets me be me. Set my course with destiny, my fine. Steering clear, a beeline sworn with drones. At least I've tried to find peace of mind. Lose your balance on the straight and narrow. Sure-footed on those bumps and bends. How come you only choose the rocky road? Maybe rocky road's the only road I know. Perhaps you can't appreciate my ways, though sometimes riddled with strife. Why force on me your Camelot? No regrets, I'd never change my life. Lose my balance on the straight and narrow.
I'm back, Jack, Mac, Flack, Whack, Hack, Sack. You know, I think I'll take a seat here. It's a nice chair. And you know, today's a little different. Not a whole lot's going on except for me, of course. You know, today you guys get to watch me read magazines, I guess. Magazines, well, let's see. Magazines about world issues. I don't want that. That's just wars and everybody shooting each other and pollution and... And people dying and car crashes and stuff. Whoa, who's that? Wow. Ooh.
Too skinny.
Only one picture in there of her. Oh, what a waste. Too much reading. Too many words. Well, how about this one? Let's see. Let's see what's going on in here. Whoa, what's that? Hey, what's going on? Let's see this. Whoa, look at that. Hey, what's going on? Hey,
it's
man. Wow. Yeah. They're everywhere. Let's see. Subscribe to this, subscribe to that. And Hey, do you ever go to a newsstand and you see all these cards all over the floor and you open up a magazine and they come flying out? I once got 12 cards in a magazine right there. I got about 50 of them. I mean, am I supposed to subscribe 12 times when I get one magazine?
Yeah.
So you know what I did, folks at home, seriously? I picked up a whole lot of these cards one time from the ground, a whole stack of them. Several times I did this, and I'd write on these cards, "Do not put so many cards in the magazine. It's a waste of paper, and they follow everything. It becomes pollution and litter, and it's stupid." And I sent them all back because why? You get free postage. It says free postage right there on every one. Well, that didn't work. So I figure I'm going to entertain. I'm going to do something. I'm going to scare them. I'm going to do something to get to shock them. So I decided I'd write all kinds of stupid stuff on these cards and just send them back. Why? Free postage. So I write stuff on these cards like, "You're fired. Don't kiss the boss's butt enough." I mean, imagine sitting there and you're working these cards and you get this kind of stuff in the mail. Like, "Quick, take off your clothes and go outside. Everybody else is. Live it up. Listen to Elvis songs with potatoes in your pants. Put one finger in your nose and the other in your butt and visit your boss. Do you pee in the shower? If so, Rubber Ducky won't like that. Read something else, stupid. This one goes to a mattress store. What's the difference between a twin bed? Imagine getting eaten by the person sitting next to you. How about peep, pop, poke, poop, pop, pap, pip, gleep? Which word doesn't belong here? How about people are strange when you're a stranger, faces seem ugly when you're alone? Jim Morrison, quote, unquote. See, it goes to People Magazine. How about advice? Clean your butthole better next time so the farts won't knock off so much crust. Oh, imagine getting that. Please send me a subscription. Name, Zizzy Zuza Zaza Googie Waga Zinga Zunga Zungi Doink 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 at 000 Non-Existent Lane, Poop Butt City, Mint State, that's State Mint, zip code 914-07-893-94666-68-12-13-14-9422. Okay, how about, this one goes to a cooking magazine. What's the difference between a wishbone? Call home, your wife's throwing tantrums and eating the dog. Remember, the fatter you are, the easier it is to do a cannonball in the pool. Once upon a time, sometimes I put stories on this. Once upon a time, there was a butthole. It's sealed up with super glue. The possessor knew this, so to keep from exploding, he starved to death.
Ew.
Once upon a time, you read this for entertainment. How's your pot belly? Whoa. I don't work there. Did you know that I'm watching and you're a badink butt butt poopy head? Wise up. Wear a spaghetti wig today. Well, that's just a sample of the stupidity that I unleash in the world to people that deserve it.
Great example of,
Yeah. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
1-2.
1-2 who?
Want to go play miniature golf today, you guys?
No.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Manure.
Manure who?
Man, you're stupid.
I like that one.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Spider.
Spider who?
Spider taking her clothes off. Oh, hey, here she comes right now. Hey, oh, no, she won't come.
Where?
Oh, well.
Where?
Oh, well. Now it's time for our food and cooking section.
Is that food plus cooking or food and cooking?
Well, we'll see. Did you know that if you ate a can of beets and drank all the juice, your wee-wee would be dark red the next day? And if anybody saw that, they'd think you're a hospital case and they'd call the ambulance and all sorts of stuff like that would happen. They might even operate you. Well, that's one way to fool people. You know, I sent out a bunch of Easter cards to different girls that I sort of knew or wish I knew. And
wish I knew.
And I figure if I sent a whole bunch of them, that maybe I'd at least get an answer. I don't know. Well, anyway, I made copies of them for reference, so maybe I can send them again next year to somebody else or somebody else at Christmas. But I don't know. It's like this one went to Clementine. I want you forever. I want you for keeps. Come to me, darling, or I'll marry my sheep. She didn't answer that one. I don't know why. How about to Skankola? This strange girl I know. Roses are red, violets are purple. When we're in public, stop fingering your butthole.
What the heck with you and buttholes?
She didn't answer that one either. Dear Sally, darling, my roses are red, my violets are genetic mutations because of pesticides, herbicides, snails, and pillars, caterpillars, and I pee on them.
Whoa.
I didn't get an answer for that one either. I don't know why.
Whoa.
This one went to Murgatroyd. Roses are red, my violets are dead. Roses have stickers, stay out of my flower bed. This one went to Snarelia. See, she's a middle-aged Marine sergeant and a real toughie. And so I wrote to her, there's tulips in the garden, there's tulips in the park. I cut off your dog's head so he wouldn't bark.
What the hell?
She didn't like that one. And this one is to Bradazilla, I think her name is. My darling, my sweetie, my honey, my babe, your armpits are so hairy, give them a shave. Now, I don't understand why I didn't get answers to any of these. This baffles me. The women nowadays, they just can't appreciate criticism. Yeah.
Or uniqueness.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Sandwich.
Sandwich who?
Sandwich is at the beach, gets really hot, so wear your thongs. All right, then. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Al K. Hall and Nick O'Teen.
Al K. Hall and Nick O'Teen who?
You lost me.
Alcohol and nicotine is bad for you, so don't smoke or drink.
Go.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Country music.
Country music who?
Whoa.
Turn off the country music. It's the same lines over and over again. It's really mental problem music. I like rock and roll.
Hey, are you fixing your cards?
No.
Oh, okay.
And now. Audience. You will all at home get out on all fours.
Oh, no.
And you will honk. You will moo. You will oink like pigs all day.
Oink, oink, oink.
Oink like pigs all day.
Oink, oink, oink.
And now?
Like Amanda.
Now I'm going for scram. Watch me go for scram.
Good job, Dennis.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Good job, Dennis.
I worked hard on that.
Okay. Happy anniversary.
Yay!
Yay! And thanks for having me here.
An old couple went riding out one dark and windy day. Upon the ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw a-plowing through the ragged skies. And up a cloud did roar. Yippee-yi-yay! Sky. Hey, yippee-yi-yo. Fire and their hearts of paper steel. Horns are black and shiny, and their hot breath he could feel. gone and ride forever on that range up in the sky. Horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. Yippee-i-yay, yippee-i-o, ghost, ghost bird in the sky. Of Paris seems somehow sadly gay. Loveliness of Rome is just another day. I'm terribly alone and forgotten in Monrovia. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my heart in San Francisco. High on a hill, it calls to me to be where little cable cars climb halfway to the stars, the golden sun may fill. My love waits there. In San Francisco. I'm on a blue and windy sea.
Happy anniversary, Night Shadow.
Thank you.
And we're back here at Horror Comic Theater, and we're lucky not only to have our good friend Crystal Man, who's been on the show a long time, we have Cookie. Now, did I hear right? Cookie the psychic dog?
She is. She is a service dog, and she is a psychic service dog. We call her Cookie the psychic wonder dog.
Wow.
I did not know what she was psychic when I first got her, but you know, when you have a service dog, you live with them and they get to know you, you get to know them, and they start being able to read your mind.
Yeah.
And now she has got where she can read other people's minds. For instance, she made a prediction today. This box of cards, I put all 52 out on the floor. She walked over, she stood on one, and then she
gave me
one card.
Oh.
And then she gave me this intense look. So I put all the cards back into the box, but the one she stood on, I reversed. The reason she did that, because she predicts that you are going to pick that card. Now, it's already hermetically sealed.
Me?
Yes. Now, if you were to look at that pack of cards, do you feel the vibrations of a heart, club, spade, or diamond?
Yeah.
Okay. Which one?
I feel the vibrations in my pants. No. I'm sorry, Cookie. I feel the vibrations of spade.
A spade. Now, would that spade be a number or a face?
A number.
And what would that spade number be?
One.
That would be the ace of spades.
The
is that correct?
Ace of spades.
Now, this pack of cards has been sitting here this whole time. If the ace of spades...
And there's nothing that we did but like before, so don't even think that. Especially from the stupid show, this is real.
Exactly. We don't need to do that when you got a psychic dog. Let me just fan these cards so everybody can see the cards are facing them. Okay. And let's see if anybody sees an ace of spades. As I, because I just kind of shoved it in here. And you can see there. Let's see. Okay, wait a second. Right. Let's see. Make sure they all see all the cards are reversed except one card right here. As you can all see.
Crystal Man, I'm going to call you out on it if it's wrong, man.
Well, now, wait a second.
We're friends, but...
If this is not the ace of spades, this is just a dog, okay, people?
Yeah,
don't be picking on the dog if she didn't get it right.
Animal abuse.
But if this is the ace of spades...
I'll clean up after Cookie today.
Well, she hasn't made any mess.
Well, wait. I'll follow you around.
Well, better still, would you just look at her with awe and admiration?
Okay.
And when you tell her, great Cookie, I'm not worthy of being in your presence.
Great Cookie, I am not worthy to be in your presence.
Well, you don't know that yet or not. That's if you're supposed to say, if this is the ace of spades.
There's no way.
Turn it over.
That's racist.
Whoa. What the heck?
Cookie, the psychic wonder dog.
Cookie. That was cool, man.
The dog has got the power. When you got the power, you got the power.
Damn, I'm impressed, man. Because like I said, you know, usually we always fake things and all that, but not this time. Good job, Cookie. Hey, clap for Cookie. What's wrong with you?
Take your bow, Cookie.
Yay! Beautiful. Hey, doesn't have your picture on there?
Oh yeah, that's my Crystal Man picture. You can show it to the audience.
Yeah. You see that? Hey, who's that little fella you got there with you? Oh, that's Vinny.
Well, that's it's a little space alien.
It's a space alien. Yeah,
Crystal Man and one of the moon people.
Wow, yeah. One of the moon people, man.
Yeah, they really do exist. They really are moon people.
Yeah, I know, because Dennis has been on here, so.
Janice has been on there? Who's
Dennis?
I'm from Planet Stupid.
Yeah, Dennis. He's from Planet Stupid.
Oh, Dennis.
Yeah.
You've been on there?
Yeah.
On the moon?
Yeah.
Did you see the people like this guy here?
I saw them. They're hiding underground.
There you go.
He's the king of them.
And he wouldn't lie.
Yeah.
Yeah. You wouldn't lie, but he'd hallucinate.
Come out someday, the far future.
That was a beautiful trick, really.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, thank Cookie. She's the one who did it.
Thank you, Cookie. So, does that mean our time is up, or do we have something else to do here?
You want to do something else?
Well, there is one more I have here.
Yeah, I want to see another trick.
Okay.
Put some cats in the room, see what the dog does.
Let me...
like to throw a rattlesnake at you.
Okay, now, what I'm going to do...
Boy, would I like to throw some hot grease on you.
I'm going to fan these cards out, okay? Like this.
Is Cookie involved in this or not?
Yes, yes. Oh, absolutely.
Dang,
okay,
Cookie
now,
man.
I have five cards here. Five cards.
Okay.
Now, what I want you to do, when I show them to you again, I want you to focus on just one. Because Cookie, if you see more than one, she won't be able to read your mind. But you're going to try to pick one of these, and she's going to attempt to pick the card that you're thinking of.
Okay.
Okay, so first look at the card and tell me when you got one.
Got one.
You got one. Okay, now Cookie, I want you to look at these cards. Cookie. Okay, which one? This one here? Okay, we'll take this one out. Okay, you sure?
I got you now, Cookie.
Okay, we'll find out now. Do you see your card? Did Cookie get your card?
It's not there. It's not in the
it's
one.
It's not there?
No.
Dog is awesome.
Okay. I'll put this card here back. And tell me now. Put that one back in there. Everybody see it? No sleight of hand. Like I'm kind of clumsy with this stuff. Is it there now?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for Cookie, the psychic wonder dog.
It was the queen of hearts. No, really? Damn.
That guy doesn't believe you.
This guy don't believe his own mother.
Well, let's see. Let's make a believer out of him.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Come on, man.
Okay, we're going to fan these cards one more time. What is your name, sir?
His name is Jihada Claus.
It's who?
Jihada Claus.
Jihada Claus?
Yeah. He's the version of Santa Claus for...
So you're a jihad version of Santa?
Yes.
Gee, you are sick.
Yes, you are.
Okay, once again, I'm going to ask you to focus on only one card now. Because remember, it's just a little...
Yeah, man.
It's just a tiny little dog. Okay, now focus on one. You got one?
Yes.
You'll remember it?
I remember.
Okay, well, you know, a lot of times people say, well... Oh, gee, I forgot what my card was. Or they say, I didn't have my glasses on. I didn't see what the card was.
I have best vision.
Okay, all right.
Flirting.
Cookie?
I want to see it again. One more time.
Cookie, one more time. Cookie, look at these cards. This one? This one? This one?
She's looking this at the one? Cards.
This one? Okay, this one here? Okay. All right. Now, she has picked a card. Let me fan these again one more time. Sir, do you see your card?
Yes, I do.
It's impossible.
That is not...
What was your card?
It was the Jack of Diamonds.
It was a what?
It was the Jack of Diamonds.
He's lying, man. He's lying. Claus.
You're lying.
You're lying.
You know what we should have done? We should have asked him what his card was before I showed him the cards.
That is crazy.
Okay, let's
do it again.
Okay,
do it again.
Okay, we are.
See what happened? What happened? See, you're.
We're gonna.
You're lying, huh?
Okay, we're.
Hey.
He can't see.
Look at the guy.
Put your dynamite away.
The guy's the damn jihadist. You know he's gonna lie. Okay.
Yeah, you damn jihadist.
Okay, now, jihad, pick one card.
Okay, I picked it.
Okay. Now, don't tell me what your card is yet, but we're going to let Cookie, which card do you think he's thinking? This one? This one?
Cookie's thinking you're a
this one? This one? This one?
That would be right.
This one here?
That's what we do.
Okay. You think that one there? Okay. You sure? Okay. Now, what was your card?
Like to see if it's in the pile.
Well, yeah, I know. Well, we will show
answer
you.
The question.
There's one, two,
stupid.
Three, four cards. They had not. They took one away.
What was your card?
The cards cannot be changed. What was your card?
It was the king.
King of what? King of clubs.
Clubs.
My friend, there's the king
that's
of clubs.
Ridiculous.
That's the card that she got.
That blew me.
Look at I just see Cookie flip you off with a little paw.
You know what I suggest you do? You go blow yourself up.
He does on the weekends. Get it? Oh, no, no.
That's crazy.
All right, Crystal Man, thank you very much
for
being on the 24th anniversary show. And Cookie, thank you.
And let me unplug myself here so we don't...
And we'll be back.
Okay, Wonder Dog.
Very good, Dale.
Thank you.